Hello learners, now we are back with the subsequent unit of the Legal Aid and PIL module of the modular program Legal Awareness. I am Kuntirani Pradhan, Faculty of Law, National Law University, and I'll be dealing with the clinical legal education aspect of the module on Legal Aid and PIL. Now, what do we study in this module? This module is basically a furtherance of all the laws that you have been dealing in your earlier subunits, earlier modules. May it be juvenile justice, may it be consumer laws, or may it be Right to Information Act. So let us know, what are we going to study in this specific subunit? Basically, we will know about the historical evolution of clinical legal education, what is clinical legal education, and how clinical legal education can be incorporated in the law colleges, law school curriculum. Finally, we'll be able to understand what is the role of an educational institution in implementing any clinical legal education course. Now, let us start about the definition and the historical perspective of clinical legal education. Clinical legal education is the inclusion of practical education to the mainstream legal education. Now, to further simplify it, let me tell you, clinical legal education is a progressive educational ideology and pedagogy which is implemented mostly through university programs. Now, why university programs? Because university programs may be through distance education courses or maybe through a virtual audience like you, we are in a better position to interact with the community as a whole. Now, you must be very inquisitive as to know how we can deal with the community through the knowledge of clinical legal education. Now, to know about the clinic, the aspects of clinical legal education, we should understand what is a clinic first. How do you establish a legal aid clinic, either in your premises, either in your college, either in your law school, or wherever you reside in? What are clinics? Clinics are basically interactive, hands-on classrooms, and there you learn by doing things. How do you learn by doing things? Is basically you have to have an interface with the community, interface with the people in itself, and you have to go and meet them in person so as to understand their regular issues and issues that through you they can address to any of the legal services authority. By legal services authority, I would again refer you back to the legal aid services module when I dealt about NALSA, where I have discussed about the state legal services authority. Also, I have told you about the district legal services authority, also the taluk legal services committees. So now you, as where the place in which you live, you may direct any of the cases pertaining to any legal aid matters to any respective forums as the case might be. To understand the concept of clinical legal education, the basic thing that you should know is community outreaching. What is community outreaching? What are the essential elements of a community outreach? Community outreach is basically going and meeting people in person, maybe a distinct community, maybe in a slum, or maybe in any area that you are residing, and with a proper interaction with these people, you can understand the issues that they face. Now, what are the essential elements of a community outreach? First, you have to know your target audience as to whom you are approaching, which is the very important and vital aspect of a community outreach initiative that you might start. The second is, you need to be very proactive in explaining that what is in for them. For example, you are going to an orphanage, you definitely need to understand and know the dimensions of juvenile justice. You should understand what is the law in place for the children, also for the orphanages. So before going to any community outreach initiative, before starting any sort of interaction with the community, please be patient enough to know about the law and to understand the proactiveness of the issue. Also, you should be very proactive in dealing with the things. The third and very important element is community partnerships. You have to build and manage community partnerships so that In case if you are not going and you are not able to understand their problem in person, through a sort of partnership, they might reach out to you, maybe through an NGO or through any person who might come and contact you for any issues. The fourth essential element is you have to be very, very responsive and you have to engage in person with the issues that the people are facing. Now, let us know about the steps that are to be taken into consideration before taking up any community outreach initiatives. Now, can we start any clinical course? Can we be allied or can we be affiliated to any clinical course in any university or college? The answer is yes, because first of all, being a student of law or being a non-student of law, or if you are not a student of law, then also you can be a part of any legal aid clinic or any legal services clinic. You can also establish one in your own community with certain degree of knowledge that is always given in the self-learning material that is being prescribed for this unit. Firstly, if you are a college student and you are opting to go for any higher education or any sort of education that you would be continuing in further course of action, then selection of clinical course is very important. Now, how do you select a clinical course? Basically, clinical course is an intervention. It is a practical implementation of whatsoever you read in theory. What is a clinical course? How do you select it? Selection of clinical course basically depends on the geographical location that you are staying. Suppose you are staying in a place which has so many slums around it. For example, you are staying in a place where you find a very important prison. So let us take for example, there are many geographical notifications, there are many geographical issues that you might find in. So for the betterment of initiating any clinic, you should know about what are the issues that are being faced by the community people. For example, in National Law University, Odisha, the clinical courses have been in 6 different areas. We work in prisons, that is prison advocacy. We work in the labor rights for migrant construction workers and also bricklayer laborers. Then we also work in the field of juvenile justice, right to information, right to education, as well as land rights. So this is just an example of how you can set up a clinical course or how you can run a clinic. It is basically very much subjective. It can depend on the area in which you stay. You can take up some examples if you are facing certain problems. If any neighborhood, any person faces any problems, you can make up a group of 3 or 4 people, those who are staying in the community. Then you can start giving them a proper awareness, but the awareness given to the people has to be very complete. It should not have any sort of misrepresented information or misinformation that give them a very bad notion about law. You should be very interactive, and interactive in the sense you should have knowledge of the law, and it does not necessarily mean that you should understand what are the nitty-gritties of the law or what are the technical words. You should not know about it, but the basic laws that accrue to that section of the society, it is very important that before moving to the field, you should know about all these things. And when you have a legal aid clinic in your college, definitely it has to be supervised by faculty members, but it can also be conducted by the student members. You can form a society of your own. You can also name it as a legal aid society. You can work in alliance with Legal Aid Society of National Law University. Also, you can have an alliance with the district legal services authority of your area in the district where you are staying. So basically, clinical legal education gives you a holistic perspective of how your knowledge can be shared, how you can spread awareness through different community outreaching initiatives. So when you go through the self-learning materials, the keywords, the glossaries, they sum up in total what clinical legal education exactly means. For your ease, we have discussed and devised all the keywords, the glossaries, also the long answer type questions, the self-assessment questions, also multiple choice questions, which you can use, you can read, and then as references, also YouTube links and references aids, the reference materials have been given, the self-learning materials. So hope you have a great experience dealing with the legal aid services, reading the legal aid and PIL as a subject, and also implementing it in a practical day-to-day life. Thank you so much.